you can't infer automatically compatibility with someone by using personality system like MBTI. Also, personality isn't nearly half as important as you think it is in courtships. These are the most important factors for sexual compatibility. Of course, for the purpose of this analysis, I'm assuming that there is sexual attraction to begin with. Otherwise, nothing will happen at sexual level. In order of importance. 1. Energetic roles. Each individual has a natural preference for masculine / active or feminine / passive role. This is determined by vital energy, specifically which side of masculine or feminine energy is predominant in that individual. Relationships are like an advanced meditation between two people. In advanced meditation, you send both masculine and feminine energy to the head. In the same way, in relationships, each partner must assume the pole of one side for the sexual attraction to remain active in order for the combined meditation to work, or sexual polarity will fade. That's why, for example, you can see a couple of gays and lesbians in which one is more the man, active masculine role, and the other is more the woman, feminine passive role. This principle applies to any romantic relationship. I covered in deep detail the psychology of masculine and feminine role in my dating coaching book, The Pandora's Box, The Forbidden Truth About Dating Relationship, available on Lulu. Link in the description. 2. Values and goals. Are your values compatible? What are your goals for short, mid and long term? For example, if someone wants to have kids at all costs and the other doesn't, well, very compatible on long term, but they might be great friends with benefits. If both values and goals are of a similar tone, then the two are compatible on long term. 3. All other factors follow up, including personality, which is useful to know to communicate better with your partner, thus keeping more easily and healthy sexual polarity. Everyone is unique. Compatibility needs to be evaluated case by case. That's it.